You want to move on from your consulting job at McKinsey, BCG or Bain or another top consulting firm and consider becoming a freelance consultant or an experienced professional with an industry background who wants to transition into consulting? You may have heard about the many benefits of a life as an independent management advisor. As a self-employed freelance consultant, you can rather flexibly arrange your work and leisure time, you do not have to worry about your boss and the next promotion, and you earn way more than as an employed consultant. At least you are curious and wonder what may be the easiest way to embark into a freelance consulting career or want to explore this opportunity. In this video, I walk you through these first baby steps of the sign-up process by advising you what to take care of when registering with a consulting marketplace that matches up clients with self-employed consultants such as Malt Strategy. Make sure you watch this video until the end as I may have a very interesting offer for you. Now let's talk about Malt Strategy. If you are an avid watcher of my channel, you may be aware that to new freelancers who want to explore freelance consulting, I recommended Comatch as the leading and largest consulting marketplace. You will get offered the most project opportunities there. There's a community and service suite built around you, and the platform cares about your long-term success. For more details, see the full video here. In 2022, some news occurred. In a merger of equal, Comatch was acquired by Malt. Previously, Malt has been a marketplace for freelancers, mostly from the tech sphere, as well as some adjacent service areas, as you can see here. Malt was founded in 2013, and at the time of production of this video, it says on its website that it has gathered more than 550,000 freelancers on its platform, who have altogether served more than 70,000 clients. However, Comatch has survived within Malt and now carries its own brand name, labeled Malt Strategy, and is introduced on the website as Malt Strategy is an exclusive community of vetted management consultants and interim executives. Essentially, Malt and formerly Comatch are trying to follow the same strategy as BCG, Deloitte and McKinsey, who all acquired and built digital services capabilities to in order to offer business and digital consulting services from one hand. Mind you that when the merger or acquisition was announced, Malt counted already 340,000 tech and other freelancers on its platform, while Comatch brought in just 15,000 former business consultants, executives and industry experts. So, while competition among business consultants is comparatively small, the project opportunities are growing. If you are an experienced management consultant or industry professional and know the secrets to setting up an attractive freelance consultant profile, you usually do not need to wait long until you get invited to board on your first projects. By the way, I am Jack and spent 5 years as a consultant and project manager with McKinsey & Company, and since then have been serving as an independent management advisor. I'm happy to help you move on from where you are right now and get started as a freelance consultant. So, how do you dip your toe into the water and sign up to Malt Strategy as a future freelance business or strategy consultant? I strictly recommend you to use my Malt Strategy sign-up link that you find in the video description below this video for two reasons. First, the sign-up process differs somewhat between Malt and Malt Strategy, and I want to make sure that you sign up to the right platform. Second, if you use my sign-up link, my offer stands to personally help you in a one-on-one call to optimize your Malt profile, and only if you want that already, to get you on your first project as soon as possible. I will say more on that in a bit. I suggest you set aside 30 minutes of your time and have your CV ready. You do not have to create the perfect profile during this first go. You can edit and improve it and risk my help later. But it has to be good enough to at least introduce your professional background to Malt Strategy. If you try to register with a dummy profile, it will be rejected. If you click on my Malt Strategy sign-up link that you find in the video description, you will be taken to this specific Malt Strategy sign-up page for consultants. Mind you, it is possible that by the time you watch this video, the design of a sign-up page may have changed a little. After you have read the instructions and start your application, you need to tick up to 2 boxes to state if your background is in management consulting or if you have served in business management line positions. Note that for management consultants, even 2 years of experience are deemed sufficient to sign up to the platform, while for business managers, at least 10 years of experience are requested. If you come from a business management position and feel discriminated, I explain you the reason behind the difference in these age restrictions in a moment. If you want to work as a freelance business management consultant, do not click on the bottom option here, as it will move you over to the sign-up process designed for Malt freelancers that work in other areas than business consulting. In the next step, Malt Strategy asks you to summarize your profile with just one punchline of 50 characters. This one actually is very important, as it presents the initial eye-catcher. I suggest you to apply excessive name-dropping here that expresses your immediate readiness for a consulting project. For instance, ex-BCG project manager and digital marketing expert, or former PwC consultant and business valuation expert, or supply chain manager, more than 15 years in automotive. Let me explain here why name dropping is important and consulting experience is valued somewhat higher than experience in line management positions. From consulting marketplaces, two types of company clients hire freelance consultants. First, industry clients that seek help. These clients are the same as the clients who also hire McKinsey, BCG or Bain for help. Second, and you may not have expected this, significant demand for freelance business consultants is also created by less famous and boutique consulting firms. Smaller consulting firms with weaker brands can find it more challenging to attract full-time employees, or they just want to remain small. But if they all of a sudden land a big project, they need manpower and need freelance business consultants. Especially this second type of clients seeks experienced consultants that do not need much training but bring the required consulting skill set with them. This is why consulting experience is valued somewhat higher than line management experience, and this is why it is so beneficial for you to showcase your past consulting experience to demonstrate your consulting readiness. The 50 character limit is a challenge, but you can still tweak your profile title later. Let me go with this one for now. Ex-McKinsey project manager, 5+ years in banking. By the way, that is not my Malt Strategy profile title, okay? Just saying, if you find this walkthrough helpful so far, please like my video, subscribe and share it with a colleague of yours who you believe should know about this opportunity too. On the next page, you are asked to select your main job category. I for myself would pick management consultant. The suggestions you get here are dependent on your profile title just defined, so if you do not like the suggestions you get here, go back and change your profile title. Then choose your experience level. Well, technically you were asked to sign up if you have at least 2 years of management consulting experience under your belt, so probably you would call yourself at least an intermediate. The next step is rather easy too. Select up to 4 out of 10 functional skills that you have developed. Be aware that your highlighted areas of competence will be used to match you with client project requests, so the more the merrier. This is also what Malt Strategy recommends itself. As a piece of advice, I would therefore highlight such functional capabilities of yours that you know are high in demand and have broad coverage, so for instance, corporate finance, M&A, due diligence, manufacturing, lean management, post-merger integration, PMO, digital marketing, corporate strategy, and digital transformation. Feel free to pick any more specific capabilities that suit your profile. I think it is of lower importance to add further customized skills down here, since they would still need to be matched with client requests. On the next page, you are asked to choose 5 industries. I suggest to be truthful, but sure you max out and really select 5 industries to improve your chances to be found when being matched with client interests. Okay, so let me pick 5 industries. The next question is a tricky one, and maybe you feel fearful about it at first. You are asked about your daily rate. Note that your rate is not immediately shown to any prospective client as such, but it is used by Malt Strategy to assess your expectations. You do not want to sell your services under value, but neither outprice you from the selection process. For a start, if you come with maybe 3 years of experience from a Big 4 consulting firm, I would confidently enter 800 euros per day here. With experience as a McKinsey project manager, you can quote twice that amount. You find some more ideas on appropriate daily rates in this video. For now, go with a lower rate. You can revise it later, and I'm also happy to help you with that. Next, select your location. This helps Malt Strategy to offer you opportunities that are not too far from you. If you can, I would definitely state that you are willing to work on-site and remotely, as well as willing to travel internationally to significantly increase the number of project offers you can expect. Then add your language skills and phone number. If English is not your first language, always put at least fluent. At the next step, you are asked to create your account. Do that and tick the two boxes at the end of the page. You're not done yet though. Now you are asked to enter some of the biographical details from your CV. I personally recommend not to use the import from LinkedIn just because it may be faster, but rather to think thoroughly how you want to present yourself on this platform and to prospective clients. When listing your professional experiences, in order to be mindful of your time, I suggest that you for now just list your two or three most relevant experiences here, just so the staff at Malt Strategy finds your profile interesting enough to approve it. Do the same in the education section. You can still add to and edit your experiences later, and I'm happy to help you with that. On the next page, you are asked to upload a professional photo. You can do it now or later. And then you are asked to write a self-description. Now, this is an extended version of this one-line punchline about yourself. So this is your personal pitch and it is important. Again, you don't have to do it now. You can draft something, but you can also just skip it. And later, we can do it together. I show you my pitch and what you can learn from it. And we craft and edit yours. Finally, you are asked about your previous freelance consulting experience. If you are just starting out, be honest and say you are just starting. Once you have submitted your application with Malt Strategy, send me a message on LinkedIn, link in the video description below, or send me an email. You can do this while you have to wait for a little until a Malt Strategy staff member reaches out to you to invite you to an onboarding call. Don't get nervous over the onboarding call. It is just to get to know each other, find out more about your preferences and experiences, and answer questions from your side on how you should present yourself on the platform. If you are actually still employed, but seriously considering to leave your current job, then I would be honest in the call and tell Malt Strategy that you are exploring and would like to find out if they believe that with your profile, you will be in demand. I'm 100% sure that even if you are not yet available immediately, if you have an interesting profile and will be available prospectively, Malt Strategy will want to keep you. So there's no risk to tip your toe into the water. After the interview and once your profile got accepted, you will be able to access your Malt Strategy account and can edit it. This is how the dashboard looks like at present. For this video, I actually managed to create a dummy account. There are a few further settings to be made in terms of preferred types of projects, your availability and so on, which we can talk through together too. If you have signed up to Malt Strategy using my link in the video description below, now you can reap your second benefit. I'm happy to have an individual and free consultation with you to review your profile and help you tweak your wording or copy about yourself, to show you my actual own role model profile and provide you with further tips on how to get started to maximize your odds of landing great projects. Sounds awesome? Yes, I know. If you find this content cool, please like, subscribe and share this video with a colleague of yours who still believes he or she needs to further climb the corporate ladder and who you think should be made aware of this better option too. Talk soon, Jack.